Hi, everybody. I'm Dr. Boots. I'm your Associate Dean for Undergraduate Education here in the School at Epps. And on Wednesday, December 9th at 5 o'clock, we are going to have a Slice and Dice with the Dean event where I teach you how to make my family's recipe for New England corn chowder. So this is a long recipe we've had in our family, and I've changed it a little bit over the years, but it's the best corn chowder you'll ever eat. And it's perfect with cold weather. So for you, to get started, you are going to have an ingredient list that you need to get in advance. That includes 3 to 5 pounds of gold or russet potatoes that you're going to peel and cut into small or medium chunks, something bite-sized. That makes it a lot easier. You're going to get at least a pound of thick cut bacon. You're not going to get anything flavored, nothing crazy like maple or anything like that for your corn chowder dish, but you can get peppered bacon. That will work out really well. You're gonna get a minimum of 4 cans of cream corn, and that's really to taste. You can do more if you like a lot of corn in your chowder. And then you're gonna buy 1 to 2 gallons of milk. You're only gonna get 2% or whole milk for the milk, and you wanna have at least 2 gallons on hand. You're gonna want 1 to 2 sticks of butter, and that can be salted butter. You're gonna get 2 sweet Vidalia onions, pretty good sized, and you're going to cut those in advance and cut those into like 2-inch pieces, 2 to 3 inch, again, bite size. They can be little wedges. You're gonna get salt and pepper and saltines or oyster crackers. And then very important, you're gonna need some equipment to start for our cooking that day. First is a large fry pan, and it's best to have a lid or a splash guard. You're gonna cook your bacon in here in advance, as well as a really large stock pot. And the larger the stock pot, the better. But for this kind of recipe where we're looking at 3 to 5 pounds of potatoes and a couple gallons of milk, you want a large stock pot. It doesn't need to be nonstick. That will make it a little bit easier. This is an enamel stock pot, and you want to have a lid on it so that you can also use that. And then you're going to prep before we meet that day. You're going to do a little bit of preparations right before we meet. You're going to peel and cut all of your raw potatoes and your onions, and you're going to boil those until they are tender, not falling apart, crumbling, but tender. So you should be able to pierce them easily with a fork, and cutting them into kind of bite size or small chunk wedges will make that a lot easier for them to boil quickly. You're gonna drain and set aside those potatoes and onions. And at the same time, you're gonna fry all of that bacon, and you're gonna place it on a cutting board. And then for the recipe, it's best not to overcook your bacon. So if you're somebody, when you order breakfast, you want it burnt, that's not what we do for this recipe. You want it well cooked, all pieces of the bacon, and then you're gonna put that on a paper towel, on a plate, or on a cutting board, and wait for us to get started. And then I will walk you through the rest of the recipe. So that's your ingredient list. It'll take us about a half hour to finish off the recipe, and then I'll give you some tips and tricks about how to make sure that you have the world's best corn chowder by the end of that meal. And I'm hoping that you'll join me. Bring your friends, and you'll be able to feed an army with your corn chowder that day. I hope to see you on Wednesday, December 9th at 5 o'clock for Slice and Dice with the Dean.